Hello everyone, I welcome you to my channel. Today I'm going to show you how to install MinGW Compiler in your understand operating system. And then I'll also show you how to run a simple C program using MinGW Compiler in your understand operating system. So, let's begin. Now to install MinGW Compiler, you need to first simply go to your favorite browser, and in the address bar, you need to just simply type MinGW distro. Then enter. And then you'll be seeing the first search result is this MinGW distro-nuwen.net. So just simply click on that. And this will going to redirect you to this official site of MinGW distro-nuwen.net. So in here, if you just simply scroll down a bit, you'll be getting a download option. So here, there are basically two links. One is MinGW17.1.exe and another is MinGW17.1 without git exe. So the best thing is you can, just simply download MinGW17.1 without git exe, because right now we don't want to use git or github. So for that, you can clearly see the file size is just only 45.1 MB. So just simply click on MinGW17.1 without git. And this is going to start downloading our MinGW. As you can clearly see, our MinGW is now currently downloading. Since I have already downloaded it, I just simply cancel it. And if I just simply minimize my browser, and if I just simply go to my download directory, you can clearly see this MinGW 17.1 without git has been rightly downloaded over here. Now the thing is, we need to install MinGW. So for that, just simply double click on it. And this will going to show you this window. Let us first minimize our download directory. And here you can clearly see it is now currently showing this path called cusers.sds/download/software. So this SDS, you'll be getting your name. I am getting, my system path. So what you need to do is you need to just simply click on this triple dot. And this will going to open this window. Here you need to just simply scroll down a bit and you'll be getting this local disk C. So just simply click on that and then just simply click on OK. And this will going to select this C:// so we are basically going to extract in this C drive. So just simply do that and then just simply click on extract. And this will going to start extracting our MinGW compiler, and you can clearly see it has rightly started. So the total size is 540 MB. So when the extraction gets complete, the file size is going to be 540 MB. Right, so this will take a couple of minutes. So what we'll be doing is I'll be coming back after installing MinGW compiler. Yeah, so we'll come back, and now you can see our extraction has been rightly completed. So just simply go to our C drive, and here you can clearly see we have this MinGW folder has been rightly created. If you just simply go inside that folder, you can clearly see all files has been rightly extracted over here. In here, you need to just simply go inside this bin folder. So just simply go inside that and then just simply click on this address bar and then right click on it and copy. Yeah. And then if you just simply click on the search icon, and here if you just simply type environ, you'll be getting this edit the system environment variables. So just simply click on that, and this will going to open this system properties. In here you need to just simply click on environment variables. Yeah. And then you need to just simply click on path, then edit, then new, and then you need to just simply right click on it and paste. So we are basically going to paste that C:/mingw/bin folder over here. So we are basically going to paste that path over here, right, and then just simply click on OK, then again OK, and then again OK. And now let us first cancel this window, and if you just simply go to this command prompt, and here if you just simply type gcc --version, and then enter, you can clearly see this gcc 9.2.0 has been rightly installed on our machine. So if you see this message, then all this basically means our MinGW compiler has been rightly installed, right? And now if you just simply cancel it, and if you just simply right click on it, and let's create a new folder over here, and let us first give this name as, let's say, C program, and just simply go inside that folder. In here I'm going to write a simple hello world program in C to basically show you how you can run a simple C program using MinGW compiler. So for that, just simply create a new text document, then just simply go inside that folder, basically file. In here, we are basically going to write a simple C program. So hash include stdio.h, then void main, then we need to create our main method. So our main method is created. Now we need to just, you know, simply print hello world. So hello world. So we have created just a void method, so we don't need to return anything. So write, you know, simply this much, then go to file, then save as, and let us save this file as prog.c. But you need to also change the save as type to all file type. That's a very important step. So just, you know, simply do that much and then just simply click on save. Yeah. And then you'll be seeing that your file has been rightly saved as prog.c. Now you need to just simply go back to your folder. This, that is basically this directory, C program directory. Then click on this address bar and then you need to just simply type cmd, then enter. And here you can clearly see this will now going to open a command prompt right at your C program directory. In here, to run this program, you need to just simply type gcc, then your file name, that is prog.c. So just simply type prog.c, then enter. And this will now going to create a new output application. You can see the name is A. So if you just simply type A, then enter, you can clearly see this hello world has been, you know, rightly shown. This hello world is actually basically coming from this program that we have written. Now this output A is not, you know, not user friendly. So what I'll be suggesting you is to just, you know, simply type gcc prog.c and then just simply give a space, then dash o. So this dash o is basically a output flag. So we have basically setting an output flag, and we want to just, you know, under this double quote, we just want to give a user friendly name. So output, then enter. And if you see now, it has, you know, right to created an output instead of A is there because that we have executed earlier, but now we have set a user friendly name output. So that output has been, you know, right to created over here after successful execution of our C program that we have written. Now to run this program instead of A, you need to just simply type output, then enter. And this will, you know, also going to show you hello world. That is basically executing our output application that we have generated, right? So in this way, you can easily install MinGW compiler and you can easily run a C program in your Windows 10 operating system. I have rightly shown you how to download MinGW compiler, then how to set our environment path, and then I have also shown you how to write a simple C program code snippet and then how to run them. So that's basically all about this video, friends. Thank you very much for watching this video. If you like this video, then please give it a like and do share it with your friends. So thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.